Hey everyone, it's Bobby from Lyco Birds with another spring warbler warm-up video, and this one is going to cover Louisiana water thrush. Now, of course, northern water thrush is the primary confusion species here. Obviously, chipnote and especially song can be a big help in separating these two, but I'm going to focus on visual identification here. So if we start with the overall structure of the bird, Louisiana water thrush looks pretty large build and kind of large headed overall, almost gives it a front heavy appearance. And contrast that with northern water thrush, it kind of looks a little more compact with a smaller bill, just overall smaller head shape, and maybe gives it a little more of a balanced feel. And if we look at plumage, obviously the plumage between these two species is pretty similar. So a good thing to look for is the contrast between the color of the eyebrow versus the color of the rear flank area. So you can see on Louisiana water thrush, you have this very bright white eyebrow. Sometimes it's a little buffy towards the front here, but if you look towards the back end, it's going to be very white. And then they have kind of these pinkish buffy looking rear flanks and undertail coverts as well. And if we contrast that with northern water thrush, both of those areas are kind of tinged with a bit of a yellowish cast. So you have the more yellowish eyebrow and yellowish rear flank area. Now, be careful because some northern water thrushes are actually very white. Overall, this is a fairly typical looking bird that has a lot of yellow tinge to it. But just don't go off pure color because some of these can be very white. So you're looking at the contrast here. You know, this is the same color as this versus decidedly not the same color on this one. And the shape of the eyebrow is something else that that's often cited. And you can see on Louisiana, the eyebrow here to the rear end kind of flares and almost looks like it wraps around the back of the head. And northern water thrush, the rear of the eyebrow is usually a little more narrow. Again, you can see on this Louisiana, you kind of have this more flared look. And again here. And you can see, again, even in bad light, this Louisiana has a strong contrast between the eyebrow here and kind of this this rear flank area. And if we look at a non-ideal angle, you can still see there's a pretty significant contrast in color here. Between this area and the eyebrow. And you can see, again, the kind of this flared look. One last thing you can look at that's often mentioned, the throat on Louisiana water thrush is typically going to be cleaner, and northern water thrush is typically going to have more of light spotting. But be very careful with that. It can be variable. Louisiana water thrushes like this one can have some light spotting. Northern water thrush, if you're not seeing it well, sometimes that spotting can just disappear. Just overall, be careful with it. And one other feature you'll see mentioned sometimes, I don't find it particularly useful most of the time, but it's something you can look for. The legs on Louisiana water thrush are often more of a bright, almost bubblegum pink color compared to darker pink on northern water thrush here, or you can see it again on this northern water thrush. So that's something you can look at, the brighter legs on Louisiana. And in terms of timing, that can also help. Louisiana water thrushes tend to be one of the very first warblers to arrive in the spring. So a water thrush very early on in the migration season is typically going to be a Louisiana water thrush. And it works the same in the fall, actually. Louisiana water thrushes leave very early. So if you have a particularly late one hanging around, it's typically going to be a northern. So if you see a water thrush in say, late August or September, typically that's going to be a northern water thrush because most of the Louisianas have left by then. So if you found this helpful, please like and subscribe for more videos like this. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.